Hello and welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Let's Play Warhammer Total War as the Vampire Kent.
I grow impatient.
At war with the evil forces of Chaos, which are mustering at our borders. You can see here, Ragnar Spitetaker is outside Talabheim, and I have no doubt that he'll try and attack the city. Up here, there's trouble brewing as well. So, overall, not a very good position for me. I do certainly need to win a few miracle battles in order to, get all of this sorted, as it were. The reconstruction thing in Eastern Sylvania also comes at a little bit of a weird time, dare I say. But at any rate, be that as it may, we have to persevere and move on, yes? Looking at all my forces, I get this weird feeling that I simply don't have enough. Yeah, I simply do not have enough to deal with everyone and everything in all directions, but to hell with it, I guess we'll find out, right? I do have the advantage of Vampiric Corruption, if it comes to that, which I seriously hope it doesn't. Like a war of attrition. But we'll see, I suppose, we'll see. Of course, the Empire targets me over the Forces of Chaos, because fucking Empire. No, back off. Back off, no. Okay, give me another turn. Alright, we're good. No, I know what they're gonna do. You're not allowed to do that. Nope, never mind. Nope, never mind. Alright. Assaulted the garrison, really. And yes, he did besiege Talabheim. That's ever so slightly strange, but, alright, that could have been a lot worse. Move in Manfred, and I really want that peace with the Empire, by the way. See if we can't finagle that into existence.
Sends his minions to threaten and parley.
No, von Karlstein sends his minions to beg for peace, because, to find ourselves in a little bit of a weird spot.
Thine right is mine. Bring their life off.
Oh god, this is going to be a battle and a half. Bernd von Karlstein, Manfred von Karlstein against two Chaos Forces stacks. Wait. I'm in no rush to die, hold on. Let's see, what else can we do to improve my odds of survival? Overall prosperity. What do we have here? We have another full stack, don't we? Yeah, we do. Can't reach Beckhoffen in time. Tell you what, let's have you move to there. So now you're within range of Kislev. And you're within range of Beckhoffen, hopefully. You can, like, go to one or the other, depending on which one gets besieged.
Champion of the dark.
Vlad. See, I can move Vlad to join the battle at Talabheim if I want to. Question being, do I want to? Well, yes I do. Let's do it.
You dare?
Yes, I dare. There we go. Fight! I'm gonna want to resolve this. All of the dislikes unsubscribed left. Not watching anymore. He's literally Satan. I would probably want to resolve this in most cases. Yeah, the more I think about it, the more I'm thinking that's the correct line of actions. Because think about it, if I don't, and I lose specific units... I'm fucked. See, this battle is not about winning. This, you need to understand this. I'm going to win this battle even without Manfred, or without Vlad, right? I'm gonna win this battle, I can, I've proven it in the last episode. It's about the way you win it, and the way I need to win it is I need to lose about 5-10% of every one of these units rather than losing specific units. You know? Like losing this entire Crypt Ghoul unit, right? I need to lose strength off of it, not the entire unit. I'll take So, no, I'm going to quick save here. And we'll auto resolve. Yeah, see, that's what needed to happen. And then I get to replenish. Sure, I get to replenish. We kill all of them. And we sit here and replenish all our forces in a turn. We did lose one unit though, and it was. Would have been ironic if it were the Crypt Ghouls, it wasn't, so it was something else, but you know, regardless. What did I lose? It was the Graveguard with great weapons, wasn't it? Most likely. So I'll raise the dead here, I think. One unit of those wolves, and. Yeah, I suppose that'll do. I grow impatient. Bow before me. Did someone level up? Not sure. I still have the mission, the Carslayer ring. I still have to do that. Trust me, I'm not doing that anytime soon. I have to raid Null, which is not really likely to happen, and occupy Aberheim, which is again not really likely to happen given the situation that we're in. So, you know what, I'll build this, and I'll conclude my turn there. See, if it didn't go down like that, I would be in a very different position right now. Like, I would be forced to... to lose, dare I say. And yeah, I would be forced to practically... either reload or something, because I couldn't pull enough troops. You catch my drift. It's not about the battle specifically, it's about the grand scheme of things. And the grand scheme of things is, I need men. I need units, specifically. They can be of varying strength, but I need them to be alive. Yeah? Because at this point, a unit with 10 men in it is far more valuable. Like, 10 units with 10 men in them is far more valuable than one unit with 100. Which, I guess, if you put it like that, is always the case, isn't it? But, Volcanic eruption. Karak Ungor. That's fine, it'll take care of itself. Alright, so... basically, we need to start kicking ass and taking names. It starts with von Karstein. I tell you what, this I will fight just because I feel like I owe you a battle against Chaos. I'm sorry if you feel cheated by that or whatever, it needed to happen. And mostly for, there's another reason, I had an epic battle last time. I don't want to have another full episode where I just have an epic battle. We need to advance the plot, yeah? So we'll skip over that. We're not doing this for battle, or at least I'm not doing this for battles at any rate. I'm doing this more for the grand scheme of things, as it were. It just doesn't feel right to have an entire episode dedicated to this epic battle and have another one that's basically exactly the same against same troop compositions. It's the most interesting thing in the world, yeah? But auto resolving is worse. I respectfully disagree. I think auto resolving is not that terrible. Sure, every huge battle it can be, but not that bad, trust me. Look, we get to do a siege. Sieges are more. I find this battle far more interesting than the big one, right? This one's less challenging, for sure. I'll win, but I find it far more interesting. There's stuff to do, there's terrain, there's things to consider. Last one was just click quickly enough on all the morale boosting buttons and pray to the lords of RNG that your morale rolls are better than theirs. You don't really roll for morale here, but you know what I mean. Alright, let's see, we have, you do have two Vardigwolves. I nearly forgot about these units, and you have four Vardigeists. This army is built for, sieges. Oh, no, this army is built for storming places, yeah? And you all get Vanguard deployment, which is about 20 meters further in than usual. I know, it's a weird world we live in. So I have badass cavalry, which I tend to forget. And the Terrorgeist! Don't forget about the Terrorgeist. Very important unit, needless to say. I dare say I won't need any of the ground troops, but, oh, let's start anyway, see what happens, yeah? Batter away in. There we go. Ooh, I probably should move in the leader of my entire faction in as well. You do that. You can't do that when they're up there, can you? No, you can't. So, what can you do? You can do invocation of that thing. That isn't that good either. Really can't cast this thing because they're up there. Right, tell you what, just get to the front lines. And behold the wings of terror. Just look at it. Is this not the most beautiful thing you've ever seen? Look at it. Well, you see, you may see a simple battle happening, but what I see is glory. To the Sindora? No, glory to the... That's a Warcraft reference. Glory to the Vampire Counts. How close are we to breaking this door? Very. Short answer, very. Cast the invocation of that thing on them, I suppose. Enemy gate is down, so we can move in with the bulk of the melee troops. Let's do this in like a desperate attempt to keep the enemies there. There you go, raise the dead, and if at all possible, see if we can hit anyone with this. Yeah, I'd say that was a decently successful hit. You're not doing anything. Go and do stuff. Go find something to kill. Then they're perfect. And for you, can also find something to kill. Like what's this? Oh, warhounds. Poisoners though. Not a big fan of fighting them. Them lot, eh? Hurry up, please. Get Vlad into the city. Oh, since you're not doing anything, might as well, yeah. Descend upon thy enemy. Oh, I do have these two. Like, down the street. You know what, send them over there. I'm sure the terror guys can use some help in dissing out the damage. Such a powerful unit, incredibly powerful unit. And you wouldn't think looking at it, right? You wouldn't think this thing is the most powerful unit in our army. No, you would think, like, it's decent. Because it's just one of them, that's the thing, that's like a little bit of a thing to get your head wrapped around. For pretty much the entirety of the game, is that no longer is it relevant whether it's one or 100. Yeah, unit strength works a little bit different. Well, no, it's not entirely true, there is still certain validity to having 100 Chaos Marauders or 100 Graveguard, but I think I personally often underestimate the power of one of these like super units, a giant or stuff like that. What did I just get? Highly unlikely. Win a siege battle without fielding any siege equipment. Well, yeah, because I usually have trebuchets, don't I? You'd think I've already done that, like, on the Let's Play. Maybe not, I don't know. I mean, according to Steam, I haven't. Fine, I don't think that's the case, but... Alright. I don't remember. I mean, it's the opposite problem, I do remember winning a few battles without any siege equipment. I guess trebuchets and catapults and stuff like that counts, so I guess not then, right? Because yeah, in my entirety of my Greenskin campaign, I had those catapults on every army. And the Vampire Counts campaign, I don't think I ever won a big siege without any siege equipment, I don't think. Huh, interesting. You don't really think about stuff like that, do you? Well, I think I won by auto-resolving a lot of the time, so... There you go. The reason I did this battle was achievement hunting, of course. What else could it be? Oh, and I love the fact that it works with mods, still, the achievement thing, because this is a mod game, right? Because of the entire Conquest thing that I modded in. Paint the map now.
Still works with that mod, which is that's only right that it should.
Gonna load in any day now. Come on.
Ah, here we go. Decisive victory for Blood Bond Carstein, a bit of loot, and most importantly, a settlement. Just occupy it. I do, actually, I do insist. And if you can build that thing, I'll highly appreciate it.
All shall know me and tremble.
I also leveled up. Undying Horde. Get the final level in that. We could also get, like, one of these things. My 25% cooldown, that's really good. That's really good. And it makes sense with the entire character in it. Yeah, I'll take it. Good, so, this puts one massive Skelliger, oh, that's not Skelliger, it's, Scaling, yes. One massive scaling army there. A total of one massive.
Do not displease me.
What's their name again? Varg, yes. One total of one massive Varg army there. And that's about it, really? Well, I mean, we do have Francie Boy down here. Being annoying as ever. Or some Katrina on the case. Maybe she'll disrupt him somehow or something. He's going to fight the elves, isn't he? And if there is kindness in the universe, the elves will win. Now, I would really like Manfred to go somewhere and do something. What? No shit. No, I would really like Manfred to go somewhere.
Ready.
And siege something and take something, yeah?
Fight.
Tell you what, I'll have you sit here. Because this is like the breakthrough force, if that makes sense. This is the big army that's going to swoop across the lands of chaos and defeat everything. Or at least that's what I'm hoping is going to happen. Get you into Beckhaven. Don't care so much about the control in this region, because I have more important things to worry about. Dare I say. Next turn, then. I'm surprised. Where are all the armies? Genuinely surprised. Where are they? Show them to me. Like, where's Archeon? And his host. Where's everything else? Fine, don't care about that. Those agents are annoying, but we have it under control, yeah?
King of Darkness. This and
you're up, lad, I suppose.
Blood.
There's literally nothing here, so might as well just click away at it. As much as I do find myself tempted to raise it, I'll just occupy it for now.
I grow impatient. Darkness comes.
See, I no longer need the garrison of Talapine, do I? No, I don't. What I need is a way to at least slow down France. But he seems to have done it himself. So, what is this thing? Yeah, I don't think your army can take care of him. I really don't.
I'll take Sigmar's throne.
Manfred should be able to. Because he's fucking Manfred. So you know what? I dare do the riskier thing. Which is this.
I hunt.
Ah, here we go. These are small armies, though. They're not a problem.
What do you want?
Amusing. Amusing situation we find ourselves in. Most amusing, certainly. There is a case to be made for sieging this as well. Well, not while they're there, obviously, but... when and if they decide to leave. There is something I want to check really quickly. We have the War Herd of Chaos, which is somewhere. We have the Warriors of Chaos, the official ones. We have Vargen Skellig. But what most people don't know is that down here is another... most people. What nobody in my empire knows is that down here is someone else. Another Chaos Army.
Talking to no bloodsucker with his...
Judging by the fact that Grimgore is a badass and two isn't shitting himself right now, I reckon that he beat these guys. Which means it's up to me to rid the world of chaos. And all I need to do that is destroy the Warriors of Chaos and kill Archaon himself. Do we know where he is? No, we don't. Not really. Which scares me. We know where most of the Skelling and Varg armies are, but they're weak. Yeah? We don't know where the bulk of the Chaos forces are, Matt. That can be a problem. Can you make it in one turn? No, which means you should probably go on a forced march. Up ahead. Alright, move on. Yes! He's going down south. Dodged a bullet a little bit, yeah? A little bit lucky there. And by that I mean, if he had moved north instead of south, it wouldn't be the worst thing in the world, but... it would be... not good. I see you. Do you really want to do that? Ah. Ah. Yes, you do. Right. Run! Run away! Alright. Now.
Your demise is certain.
We shall conduct... cowardly tactics. Of, basically, let them come, come and have a go if you think you're hard enough, so on and so forth, yeah? But they did just open up an avenue, I guess, for Vlad to move in. The Castle von Rauken. As risky as that might initially seem.
And I will take Brass Keep up here. Again, almost no garrison in it. Allows me to secure the province and get Vampire Corruption in it. No, Rest the Mortals, get Public Order in it instead. Tell you what, I'll run over here. In the most cowardly of tactics known to mankind. Yeah, I'll run over there. And that should mean that if you get attacked, these guys will help, but let's do that just in case. If that doesn't come to pass and there's like a millimeter of space between the two. Just say their lines of influence aren't touching.
Not likely.
This wouldn't be a bad opportunity to have a go at Francy Boy either. But he is healing his men, so. Do you know what? Instead, I will. Huh. Vampire Camp Rebels, nice. I'll instead just garrison you with Bloodbard and defend against him rather than take a more proactive approach. So is this thing being besieged? I assume this is the, you know, them fighting against them, if that makes any sense, yeah? And no actual Chaos forces down south, because if Chaos is down south as well, well, we're boned. They didn't stop them, because, you know, if they get the steamroll down there too, like I said, we're boned. I'll raise. No, I'll occupy it properly. Never mind. Get in there. Get in there. Take it. Take everything from them.
King of Darkness.
Leveled up again, that's good. Give you Power Drain, I think. Make a really good caster. So, there is an army there, which I'm worried about, but, okay, we're defending against 1, 2, 3 Skellig armies, which are taking attrition, and they will take a lot more come next turn. Because, yeah, they just ended their turn there and began the next one. I'm not sure how much attrition that is. It could be, I think it's just one turn of attrition, though I desperately hope it's two. But for some reason, I'm pretty damn sure it's not two. But yeah. Be what it may. It helps. See what they do. Oh, you want to fight? Yeah, we'll fight. We'll fight, that's good. It's good. It's not good, but, you know, we'll fight. If that's what you want. I'll make it back to Castle on Malcolm, right? Make it back to there, they can't make it to Malcolm. He said to himself in a terrified voice, they can't make it back, right? Right? That was, by the way, one worth attrition. So, yeah. Gonna fight this battle next time. Thank you very much for watching, ladies and gentlemen. Like, subscribe down below if you enjoyed the video. Take care. Bye-bye.
Yeah. This is gonna be tough.